supply chain control tower contains a lot of features and functionalities, but to be more on a realistic side, where we are and where we stand today, there are certain features that we can leverage today. Not everything is properly integrated, other systems and all. So today in this demo, I will custom alert, and those are automatically displayed when a particular custom alert is generated with the basic criteria or the rules that we set. And from here, we can control the alerts and the exception at a global level, regional level, or at a high level. And from there, whatever subset we assign to group of people, they can basically come into case management. From here, they come to the alert, they follow the procedure playbook, and from there, they basically take corrective actions. And the moment the corrective actions are taken, if I come here and refresh my, just a second, I think I have to go out and come back. And I come back and refresh, you see, I have now one alert layer. So that means, in a way, when a group of planners are working on alerts, taking corrective action, snoozing them, or closing them, I can, from this dashboard, see what are the actions are being taken, because my count of alerts or the alerts that will be coming here in large numbers will gradually come down. So that is one of the relationship that we can basically see while viewing things at an intelligent visibility profile, which is at a more global level, assigning exceptions to subgroups where they take actions, and whatever actions and progress they take, the impact of that can also be seen back in the global intelligent visibility profile as well. So till now, before I proceed further, any questions?
No. Very interesting. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Now, I showed you the part wherein you basically look, collaborate, assign, track, and whatever has been completed, that gets updated here. Now, there is an additional functionality as well. So if I am looking into an alerts, why it is dancing like this? So in the alerts from here, we have one more functionality that from here I can select the alert, and then from here I can go to monitor custom alert, which I have shown you through the case management. Here we have one more functionality, that is, we can go to the Excel add-in. This might sound very interesting, but this feature will further be enhanced in the upcoming 2402. But at this point of time, what this does is, that is what I'm going to show you. So if I select all the alerts or any particular alerts per se, and I come and say, go to Excel add-in, it basically creates a CSV file, which I need to save somewhere in my desktop. And once this file is saved, and I open this, it basically opens up the template that we have assigned in the custom alert and directly takes us to that template and shows up the alert key figure with the combination of the alerts that I have selected in the intelligent visibility profile. So let the data load. So you see it basically, I have come here, selected this alert, and I have gone to Excel. It directly brings me here. Now this functionality is relatively new functionality. So if you see here, it has opened a new session, but the template is the same template, which is the inventory template style, which we have added in the custom alerts. Now here it only shows the key figure that we have used in the custom alert, but down the line in the next release 24.02, it will not only show this alert, but at the same time, it will show you all the key figures that we have in this respected planning view, so that I don't have to log in every time. I can select a set of product, open it, and this view will open with the predefined products that have been generated in the alerts, and those products will only be displayed here. So in a way, I can directly come to Excel with these predefined products, focus on them, take corrective actions, save the changes, and come back here and select all this and say snooze, or it's done for me. So even I can do those corrections in mass mode in Excel by selecting a bunch of alerts, take corrective actions and snooze them or close them in batches and save them here. So this is also one feature and functionality that is available and possible from this intelligent visibility.
Just a quick question, sir. And I may have missed this part. When you resolve one of the alerts, where would it go? Like, where would I be able to see that alert once it is resolved?
So here in this intelligent visibility profile only you can see. So if you see, Gurpreet, here we have something called alert status. So if you in the drop down, it will show you active, snoozed and all. So I will just select snooze and click on to go. So you see, number of closed alert is 1. So if I come here and see, it will show me only that alert that has been closed. And it gives you this icon because it says that it is assigned to a case and it has been closed. If for some reason, as a cluster planner or a group planner, I want to basically reopen this alert, all I need to do is to select this and activate it. So it will be unsnoozed and that alert will appear again. Does that answer your question, sir?
Yeah, so it will start appearing on the complete list along with the other 6.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is the play option. Means here, if you select all, you will see active and closed. If you see select active, only the active ones. If you see snooze, the closed ones.
So everything, every alert will remain in the snoozed forever, or is there a time period till which it will remain, or after that it'll kind of disappear?
I will show you. That's a very valid question. So if you, I don't know why it is dancing like this. So if you snooze and select the option snooze for all, you get 3 options. Snooze until a particular date, snooze until data changes, snooze indefinitely.
Right.
So you can use these options.
Okay. So basically the status closed, they are calling snooze.
Snooze, right? Yes. Closed is snoozed, yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
No problem, sir. Now, Now, from a supply chain control tower, although my objective was to show you intelligent visibility profile, case management and procedure playbook, and how we can control or basically see all exceptions at a global level, do assignments, track them. There is also something which is part of supply chain control tower, which is not yet integrated with intelligent visibility profile, that is called Sandeep. You mind if I go to analytics story a bit?
Oh, please go ahead. Yes, it's interesting.
Okay. So we have something called analytics story. Now, what is analytics story? It is kind of an advanced dashboard wherein you can put various chart tables and create a dashboard that makes more sense for presentations. So it is also a part of supply chain control tower. So I will just go. This is something which is not fully prepared, but whatever I could based on the data that we have. I have created, it is still in progress because there are bits and pieces which even I am figuring it out as well, to be very honest. Something went wrong. What went wrong? Everything went wrong. So it basically does an authentication to check whether this URL has a control tower license and or not. If it doesn't, it doesn't load this analytics story. So this is a kind of a dashboard that I am in the process of preparing to basically give you more sense of how analytic dashboard and in a say a data control tower look like. So there are multiple pieces to it. So we can create a dashboard, a story like this, wherein we can put small, big, or different kind of widget, which doesn't necessarily have to be charts all the time. It could be numbers, it could be a graph, and it could be bubbles, heat maps, etc. So if you see, I am basically trying to create a dashboard specific for Broadloom. So based on whatever data I have, I am collecting. So if you see one such thing that I am doing here in terms of visualization is, I am trying to see the error CV in bubbles by style and owner. So the bigger the bubble, the higher is the error CV. So first thing, if you look into this, one thing that gives a visualization is my product class is Broadloom. And all the styles that I could see inside Broadloom, majority of it by the color I can see, most of them are residential, few of them are commercial in nature. And I could see there are error CVs of 0.8, whereas I could see there are error CVs of 0.35. So this is one kind of visualization, and there are multiple other widgets like safety stock comparison, which I have done for the first 4 months. As in, what was the safety stock in month 1, 2, 3, and 4? What is the safety stock coverage, safety stock and its coverage month wise? And in the current month, what is the final safety stock that I am holding? So these are the different kind of widgets that we can build in this analytics story. And we can make a story out of it, which will not just be inventory optimization, but a combination of demand, IO, supply, all coming together in different widgets, forming a story, forming a storyline, and becoming a dashboard like this. So I just wanted to share the features and the functionalities that are available, the more we get data rich and data oriented, we can make more sense of this analytic. So in a way, if you see intelligent visibility and this analytic stories, these are primarily high level of a control tower or a control dashboard from where you can see how your entire end-to-end supply chain is performing, where are the issues, if anywhere the errors, and from there even you can dive down, look into details, and then basically take corrective actions. So this is another part that I wanted to show you.
Thank you, and thanks a lot for watching this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so that you can get notification of my coming videos from IBB Live.